All right, today we're gonna be learning how much power this 10 plus year old solar panel still produces. And we're gonna be doing that with this AC-DC amp clamp meter. Lewis Angel right here with Ryzen, and I'm out here in the shade right now, but we're about to go to the sun to measure and use this Klein meter right here to measure the amps and also the voltage so that we can calculate the wattage for this solar panel. I actually bought this on Facebook Marketplace and it was used. I bought it for like $40, so I knew what I was getting when I bought it. So it's not like they bait and switched me or anything like that. So I knew what I was getting, but I just wanted to test it out. Okay, it was $40, 190 watts originally is what the manufacturer says that it produces. All right, so as you can see, this one looks pretty old. It looks brand. How you can tell is you see some sun damage already here. Now, I don't know exactly because I don't know where they came from, what type of roof they had, what type of system they had, the inverter, the battery system. I don't know what they had. They were just selling a bulk of these, so I took one as a to test it out. And there's also some more sun damage, as you can see, like on the connections between the cells. So you see a lot of sun damage here, and or because we don't know the actual setup, it could also be from the system itself. So either from the inverter, the charge controller, the battery system, it could be from the main panel itself. Nonetheless, there is some, but does it work? Does it still produce our free energy? Let's find out. So we're gonna go ahead and connect. And I have this amp meter, the clamp one. You can also get test this out with the regular voltage meter, but I am gonna use this one because it's a lot easier to test the amperage. So I'm gonna go ahead and connect the leads here. So we're gonna connect the negative lead here and then the positive one. Boom, red to positive. Okay, so I went ahead and you can change it. I have it set to voltage here and I went ahead and changed it because it starts off at AC. So I'm gonna put it at DC so it can read the DC voltage coming out of this panel. Now this one, originally when it was manufactured, the open circuit voltage is set at 32.8 volts. Now there, you can see a lot of damage on it already. So due to various factors. So we're gonna go ahead and connect the positive lead to the positive side of this cable, and then the negative one here. And you can see that the voltage is actually at 28.45. The sun is almost perpendicular to the way that I have this panel set up, but it's been pretty consistent. I've been testing it out at different times of the day, and it's been pretty consistent at over 28 volts. So that's really good, 28.4. Now, 32.8 was the original open circuit voltage. So that's a drop of over 4.4 volts over the last 10 plus years. So as you can see right there, a lot of the power that this solar panel is able to produce has dropped dramatically, but it still works, it still works. So now you wanna do this kind of quickly because you don't wanna leave this on short circuit for too long, but we're gonna go ahead and short circuit this, and that just means we're gonna connect the positive to negative cables here. Now we're gonna switch this to 40 amps, and then we're gonna open the clamp and we're gonna place it. Oh, let me change to DC, okay. So I just changed this to DC so that it reads the DC amps. And as you can see there, it's 5.23 amps. 5.23 amps, that's what's going through this panel at the moment and through these cables. Let's go ahead and disconnect this. All right, so let's jump over to the iPad so that we can see and do some quick math of what the drop is. So we can see that I already did it for volts and we'll do it for amps in a moment. So we can see that the original, right here, 32.8 volts at open circuit. And that's, again, 10 years ago, that's what this was at the warehouse where it was being tested. Now today we got 28.45 volts and that's pretty much what I've been getting over the last few days that I've been testing this, around 28 to 29 volts open circuit. So that's a loss of around 4.4 volts over the last 10 years. Let's go ahead and do the math on the amp side of things. So amps at short circuit, so that we see that the original was 8.05 amps. And this, what we did today was 5.23 amps. Again, that it's been up and down, so around 5 to 6 amps, sometimes lower, obviously, if there's a cloudy day, or if the sun is being blocked for some reason, there's shade on the panel, then we're not gonna get anything here. We'll get very little to nothing. But for now, we're getting 5.23 amps. So we can see that the loss on this was 2.82 amps. So that's what we lost. Now, we know that the NCL says that on average, you're gonna get a minus 0.4% degradation. So that means loss of power every year that you have these panels installed. This looks like a lot more. So we'll do some more math on that in a moment. So as you can see there, this panel still works. I'm gonna connect it and do a full test later, but for now you can see that there's still voltage being produced. There's still amps running through as well through these cables, so that we know that if we hook it up and there's something going on, it more than likely is not coming from the panel. There's something else going on with your system. But this panel, although it's old, it's degraded, we see some damage to it already, just because it's a over 10 years old, over a decade old panel, but it still does produce electricity. It still produces free electricity for you to use. So we see here year zero is 32.8. So that's what on the day that this was manufactured, that's the open circuit voltage, the 32.8. We measured much lower than that. Now, I put the values in of 0.5% loss per year here. So you can see year one, it should have been 32.64. Year five should have been 31.99. Supposedly these panels are 10 years old, so 31.20. We got much lower than that, as we had seen before. So I did another calculation. So I said, okay, what if it's at a 1% loss? So 1% loss per year, starting off at 32.8 for year zero. I believe that it's closer to like 14 years old, so 28.4, because that looks about what I'm normally getting, like 27, 28 volts. So that's pretty consistent. So we're seeing here with this panel, we're seeing a loss of about 1% per year due to various conditions. This one was a little bit more beat up, so it could be 10 years old and it was just, you know, not well taken care of. So for voltage, not for amp, but for voltage, we're seeing that it has lost about 13%. So 13% right here, 13% of its original stated open circuit voltage power rating. Now, would I recommend for you to go through Facebook Marketplace and buy some used panels? Well, it depends. Now you know that if you wanna go do it and you wanna actually use it to mount it, I wouldn't mount this myself, but if you wanted to, make sure to take a meter and test your panels before you go out and buy it, so that you know exactly what you're getting. Because if you're getting a good, clear, sunny day, no clouds in sight, and there's nothing blocking this panel, and you're not getting voltage or it's very low compared to what it's originally manufactured for, then don't buy it. If you're getting zero amps on it, there's something going on with the connections at some point on this panel, so don't buy it. But also, if you want to just like get it just to test it out, have fun with it, you know, by all means do that, go ahead and purchase it. But see, the reason why I bought this is just to run some tests. I'm actually going to break it down also after I'm done with some tests. I'm going to break it apart to look inside of it. It was only $40. All right, that's it. My name is Lewis Angel with Ryzen. Make sure to subscribe, like, share, comment down below what types of videos that you want me to make next. Battery videos, more solar panel videos, some more education based videos. I'll teach you what a watt is, what a volt is, all that stuff. Make sure to subscribe, and I'll see you on the next one. Peace out. Keep learning, keep growing.